said the first book that you have written, you published that openly. Go ahead and read.
That the worthy and unworthy may read it.
That the worthy and the unworthy may read it. Go ahead and read.
But keep the 70 last.
But keep the 70, it say 70?
70 last.
70 last. Go ahead.
That thou mayest deliver them only to such as be wise.
To, but only deliver these 70 to only as such as be wise. Uh-huh.
Among the people.
Among the people, uh-huh.
For in them is the spring of understanding.
For in them, these 70, because remember they wrote 100 and something, 200 and something letters or whatever. But these 70, though, we're only going to give it to those that are wise. Because in the spring, we'll read that again, that last part.
For in them is the spring of understanding.
For in them is the spring of understanding, uh-huh.
The fountains of wisdom.
The fountain of wisdom, uh-huh.
And the stream of knowledge.
And the stream of knowledge. But these 70 letters, or whatever you want to call them, are not in there. They're not in this Apocrypha. They're in the annotated, Cambridge annotated Apocrypha. Cambridge, you know, the Gentiles. You understand? Like, there's another one too. I forget the other one right now. So now, those 70 are not in this book, the Apocrypha. They're in the Cambridge Cambridge annotated Apocrypha. So now we're going to read these, some of these, what's written in there. This was supposed to be read to the wise people. You understand? So now, title right here.
70 missing verses in 2nd Ezra.
70 missing verses in 2nd Ezra. What else is saying?
Hell, the pit of torment.
The hell, the pit of torment. See, now this is what the Lord was supposed to be telling Ezra, these 70 verses that's missing. He's supposed to be telling them about hell. So you tell the wise people about this, but don't tell the rest of the people. Come on, man. Why would God, if this was something with the word of God, why would he want to hide it from people? I mean, you would tell the people so they won't go there, right? Amen. Turn the page. Go ahead and read that.
2 Ezra 7, 36 through 105.
Now, we ain't going to read all that. The 70 verse, we ain't going to read all that. Go ahead and read it.
The pit of the torment shall appear.
Now, he tell them now. This is one of the part of the 70 that was given, verses that was given to the wise. It said the pit of the torment shall appear. Uh-huh.
And the opposite, it shall be in the places of a place of rest.
And the opposite shall be a place of rest. Uh-huh.
And the furnace of hell shall be disclosed.
Uh-huh.
And opposite is the paradise of delight.
Wait a minute now. So on one side of hell, you got darkness and torment. On the other side, you got light and delight. Go ahead and read.
Then the Most High will say to the nations that have been raised from the dead.
Uh-huh.
Look now and understand. Whom you have denied.
Now this is what he's going to say to the ones that's been raised from the dead now. Look whom you have denied. Uh-huh.
Whom you have not served.
Uh-huh.
Whom commandments you have despised.
Uh-huh.
Look on this side and on that. Here are delight and uh-huh. rest.
Now he said, look on this side and that. Now these ones have been raised from the dead now. He tell them, look on this side and on that side. Here are delight and rest. Uh-huh.
And there are fire and torments.
And there are fire and torments. Go ahead.
Thus he will speak to them on the day of judgment.
Thus he going to speak to them on the day of judgment. So he going to raise the people that have died. First they down in hell. You understand? On one side is light and spring water. You understand? On the other, paradise and delight. And the other side is darkness and torment. Now, let's, you know, the Bible don't speak nothing about this. I mean, if the prophets would have told you about this, if this was true, the prophets would have mentioned this, the apostles would have mentioned this. Somebody in the Bible would have mentioned this. First of all, you know, and so let's go now, let's go to Ezekiel, the 18th chapter. Ezekiel 18. We ain't got much more to go. Ezekiel 18. Ezekiel 18 and 20. Ezekiel 18 and 20. When you get it, brother, go ahead and read that.
The soul that sinneth, it shall die.
The soul that sinneth, it shall die. That's this body. This body dies, don't it? Go ahead and read.
The son shall not bear the iniquity of the father.
Uh-huh.
Neither shall the father bear the iniquity of the son.
Uh-huh.
The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him.
Uh-huh.
And the wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him.
The main point, he said, the soul that sinneth, it shall die. Now, let's go to let's go and show you what this soul that's died. What's gonna happen to it? We know it's gonna die. But you know, you got some people say that your soul is going down, or your spirit going down into hell, and part of it is gonna be in light and delight. You understand? Or if you was good, you're going to light and delight. But if you was evil, you're going to darkness and torment. Let's go now. Let's go to Ecclesiastes, the 9th chapter. Ecclesiastes 9. Somebody, see, the prophet's going to tell you what happens to those that die. The prophet's going to tell you. And if it don't line up with these prophets, then this not the word of God. Ecclesiastes 9 and 1. Ecclesiastes 9 and 1. Go ahead and read.
For all this I consider in my heart,
uh-huh,
even to declare all this, that the righteous and the wise,
uh-huh,
and their works are in the hand of God.
See, the righteous and the wise and their works are in the hand of God. Go ahead.
No man knoweth either love or hatred by all that is before them.
Uh-huh.
All things come alike to all.
All things come alike to all. Not no one side, this side, you in hell, light and delight right here. Because some people say it's water and spring water and light on one side of hell. The other side is darkness and torment. But he said all things come alike to all. Go ahead and read.
There is one event to the righteous.
Uh-huh.
And to the wicked.
Go ahead.
To the good and to the clean.
Uh-huh.
To the unclean, to him that sacrificeth.
Go ahead.
And to him that sacrificeth not,
uh-huh,
as is the good, so is the sinner, and he that sweareth,
uh-huh,
as he that feareth an oath.
Go ahead.
This is an evil among all things that are done under the sun,
uh-huh,
that there is one event unto all.
There is one event unto all. Everybody understand this? One event unto all. Go ahead and read.
Yea, also the heart of the sons of men is full of evil,
uh-huh,
and madness is in their heart while they live.
Uh-huh.
While they live,
uh-huh,
and after that they go to the dead.
They go to the dead. Everybody go to the dead. Everybody. One event happens to all. They all go to the dead. Go ahead and read.
For to him that is joined to all the living,
uh-huh,
there is hope.
The living, there is hope. Go ahead.
For a living dog is better than a dead lion.
A living dog is better than a dead lion. Why?
For the living know that they shall die.
Uh-huh.
But the dead know not anything.
Ooh, the dead don't know nothing. So ain't no they going down into hell and one part is light and delight and they enjoying themselves down there. And then on the other side is darkness and torment. Everybody goes to the dead. When you die, everybody goes to the dead. He said, For the living know that they should have died, but the dead know not anything. They don't know nothing. Go ahead and read. That's dead, eh? Go ahead and read.
Neither have they any more a reward.
Uh-huh.
For the memory of them is forgotten.
Go ahead.
Also their love.
Hold it. Also their love, so they can't be down in hell then. Loving the spring water and light and all this kidding. He said, also their love, uh-huh,
and their hatred,
uh-huh,
and their envy,
uh-huh,
is now perished.
Is now perished. Everything that the person that was living when he died, he don't own nothing no more. love, hate. He can't think of nothing. It is fade to black, baby. That's it. Finish that.
Neither have they any more a portion forever in anything that is done under the sun.
Skip down to verse 10.
Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave, whither thou doest.
I mean, that's plain scripture there, ain't it? So now, in the Apocrypha, though, in Cambridge and the Native Apocrypha, they said that you go down into hell, and one side is light and delight, and the other side is darkness and torment. I read before, it was talking about light and spring water on one side, and the other side is darkness and... But look, Solomon tell you right here, whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave where thou goest. You don't know nothing in the grave. Ain't no light and spring water on one side and death and torment, darkness and torment on the other side. Let's go now. Let's go to, we're going to read you something right here. Now let's go to Psalms. Let's go to Ecclesiastes, the third chapter. Ecclesiastes 3. You see how you can prove them wrong with the Bible. You can show that this Apocrypha don't line up with the prophets. You can show that the lost books of Eden, they don't line up with the prophets. They don't line up with the apostles. If they don't line up with the real church fathers, which are the apostles, then this is not inspired by God. This is inspired by man. Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, Ecclesiastes 3, and we're going to pick it up at verse, before you read Ecclesiastes 3, we're going to read something here. We're going to read something. We're going to read about Sheol. This is what they call it, Sheol. They don't call it hell. They make it sound better with saying Sheol. Right here, read that.
Sheol. In the Old Testament, a place under the earth.
In the Old Testament, a place under the earth. What? Where do you see that in the Old Testament? Go ahead and read.
Where the departed spirits were believed to go.
Oh, you see that? In the Old Testament, this is where the spirits that have departed, I guess departed from the body, this is where they go. And they go down into this light, because that's what it's talking about, this light on one side of hell and darkness on the other side of hell. And torment. You finish that?
Yes, sir.
All right. So they call it Sheol. Now let's see if this is in the Bible. Let's go to Ecclesiastes, the third chapter. This is where the spirit's supposed to go. Ecclesiastes 3:16. Ecclesiasticus, which is in, I think that's in the Apocrypha too. Now we talk about Ecclesiastes, which is written in the book in the Bible. Ecclesiastes 3:16. Go ahead and read it.
And moreover, I saw under the sun the place of judgment, that wickedness was there, and the place of righteousness, that iniquity was there. I said in my heart, God shall judge the righteous and the wicked, for there is a time wherefore every purpose and for every word.
See, he's going to judge the righteous and the wicked at the same time. Go ahead and read.
I said in my heart concerning the estate of the sons of men, that God may manifest them, and that they might see that they themselves are beasts.
Because that's all man is. We're just beasts. That's all we are. You understand? We breathe. The animals got to breathe too, don't they? We go to the washroom, the animals got to go to the washroom too, don't they? Go ahead and read.
For that which befalleth the sons of men befalleth beasts. Even one thing befalleth them.
Go ahead.
As the one dieth, so dieth the other.
See, so one die, we die just like the beasts die. Go ahead and read.
So dieth the other. They have all one breath.
They have all one breath. That is that spirit that God have put inside of me.